Okay, gabi na. At beginning na ng lesson on electricity. Kung nagtataka kayo, bakit langit na nakikita niyo? Well, yun ang simula ng lahat. Okay, so para hindi kayo magtaka ako na ano start, ang lesson ko is about electric charge. So electric charge sa being first topic ng first quarter ng third quarter ng second ng general physics 2. And this is the first topic to be discussed. And obviously, sa screen, makita nyo na ang definition ng electric charge. Okay? It's a quantity associated with electrical phenomena. So, when you say electrical phenomena, anything na ma-involve ang kuryente, lightning, nag-charge kayo ng cellphone, magre-recharge kayo ng cellphone, na-discharge ang battery, okay, na ground kayo na kuryente, na electrocute, all of them are associated with the concept of electric charge. Most of the time, na-experience yung electric charge, dalawang klase lang naman eh. Either yung static or yung current. But anyway, a charge can be either negative or positive. Sabi dyan, it has a symbol of Q, capital or lowercase. And meron din siyang MKS unit na coulomb. So, GS unit niya, Franklin, ESU or electrostatic unit or stat coulomb. And ang symbol ng unit niya is capital C. So, what are the laws associated with the concept of charge? Okay. The first one is called the law of charges. And it states that charges of the same sign repel each other, while charges of different sign attract each other. All in all, it only means sense ang charges, as discovered by Benjamin Franklin from the beginning, inassign niya ang dalawang charges na positive at negative. So since positive and negative sila, that means they tend to cancel each other out, their effects. Although they actually don't cancel the forces, they just tend to change the direction when they come up to each other. Yun ang ibig sabihin ng law of charges. So, when you have a positive sign and a negative sign, they attract. And ang sum ng charges nila is zero. But the forces existing at that point are still there. Hindi sila actually nakakancel. Okay, naaano lang sila na yung effect lang nila, yung net force lang nila, tend to become zero. But for a positive and negative charge, hindi actually na nullify yan. In fact, a positive and negative charge will have a net force. Okay. So the next law is also called the law of conservation of charges. It states that the net charge of a system is zero, and any manifestation of net charge within a system means a transfer of unit charges or a redistribution of charges. Now, ano ibig sabihin yan? Okay, so let's now look at a PowerPoint presentation. Okay. Meron akong ginawang ano, drawing dito sa PowerPoint presentation na to. And sa drawing na to, makikita nyo na there are 10 by, not 10, but 5 by 5 sets of charges. And they're all equally distributed. So, positive, negative, and so on. Alternating positive and negative. So, the blue with the plus sign is a positive charge. The red with the minus sign is the negative charge. Now, a net effect nito is zero. All you have to do is count the number of charges. Kasi sabi nga, ang system daw, ang sum of the net charge niya is always zero. So, if you count the number of pluses here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 8, 11, 12, 13. Actually, may sobrang charge na is, may siya sobrang charge. Kasi there are 13 charges na positive and 12 charges na negative. So, actually, meron siyang tinatawag na net charge. So, to make that null and void, gawa tayo isang negative. So, saan natin siya lalagay? Yun ang problem. Dito? O doon? Since 25 ang original number, odd number yon. So, medyo, kung odd number, that would mean that the number would have an extra positive or a negative charge. In this case, it's an extra positive charge. Now, originally, if kung tatanggalin natin tong dalawa, no, this one, the net effect of these charges is neutral. Meron din siyang forces acting on each other. So, notice if you have a positive and negative dyan, magdidikitan niyan. As in, they will probably fall into a ball. Especially kung spherical ang positive at saka negative dyan, they will form into a ball. Trying their best to connect to each other, the positive with the negative, negative with the positive, and yung mga positive and negative charges will try to repel from each other, forming what you call more of a, possibly a spherical shape. On the other hand, when you say naman na, sinabi dito kasi net charge of a system is zero, and any manifestation of net charge within the system is a transfer of unit charges. So, what we're going to do is we're going to move some charges here and there. Now, we already have a charge here. So, net effect again, ang net charges is zero. So, in order to have what you call what appears to be a net charge, i-redistribute natin in such a way na mayroong sobrang positive at sobrang negative sa iba. Say, I place it here, no? Yan. And get some more negative here. Ayan. Then, some more negative here. Ayan. Mukha ng tao, no? And notice that, ang una-una mapapansin, medyo mas maraming positive, negative dito. Sa part na to, dito naman, mas maraming positive. So, meaning, there's a net charge of negative on this side, and a positive charge, a net positive charge on this side. That means the charges were redistributed. Which also means that even if there's a net force, a net charge here, there is a, the overall net charge, there is a segment of the system that is slightly negative, and a segment of that system is slightly positive. It appears that that segment is negatively charged, and that segment here is positively charged. So that accounts for the concept of the net charge within a system. Merong slight redistribution. Assuming kunin ko pa to, no? Transfer ko pa dyan. Same thing with this one. Again, this one has a lot of negative on this side and a lot of positive on that side. So again, the net effect is negative on this part and positive on that part. So I hope you understand the meaning of the law of conservation of charges. The law of charges, on the other hand, is just about the pushing and pulling of each other charges, no? So the positive and negative, they pull each other together. And the same charges as such as both negative or both positive, they push each other. Okay, so as to why they do that, that is beyond the realm or the scope of physics, kasi the physics usually describe things. So ang subject of physics, when they see a phenomenon, they tend to describe it, and then they make some best guesses of how that works. However, the why part is rather difficult to answer. So, bakit positive siya? Bakit negative siya? Of course, we can say the origin, but never as to why inherently positive or why inherently negative siya. That's something na beyond sa scope ng ating pag-study. Needless to say, ganun pa din ang concept na madedevelop. Okay, so now, if you have any more questions concerning the law of conservation of charges, we'll proceed to the next part of the topic. Okay, so punta muna tayo sa Word. Again, MS Word. So after the law of conservation of charges, we now proceed to others. So this one says something like, charges are quantized. So what do you mean by quantized? The term quantity, quantize, quantum, well, they have the same origin. In Spanish, cuenta, parang ganon, count, to count, or contar, to count. Now, when say charges are quantized, it means that parang imagine mo, ang let's say meron kang isang charge, compare mo yun sa isang kilo ng bigas. Isang kilo ng bigas is made up of thousands of kernels of rice, rice kernels. So imagine mo yung kernel na yun, that's a quantum ng charge. Meaning, you have a total mass of a of rice, and we're quite sure that if there's an average mass of a kernel of rice, of a single grain of rice, you can say that that yung rice itself, for example, is quantized to its individual grain. Okay, so ganun din ang charges. So any charge that you measure actually is actually made up of a collection of charges that are unit charges. In this case, in MKS system, ang unit ng charge is positive or negative 1.60 times 10 to the negative 19 coulomb. A very small value. However, ang coulomb charge is a rather large unit. It's a very large unit. So 1.60 times 10 to the negative 19 coulomb, that's the unit, meaning there is no such thing as 1.65 times 10 negative 19 coulomb, nor negative 3.23 times 10 negative 19. It has to be multiples of 1.6 times 10 negative 19 multiples. O pwedeng 3.2 and so on. Okay, 3.2, that would be 6.4. So in a way that you can get a portion of the electric charge as holes, buo-buo siya, hindi siya pwedeng other values. So there can be no value that is between 1.6 and 3.2 times 10 to the negative 19. It jumps, nag-jump siya by 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19. On the other hand naman, ang friction at ang induction are ways to charge. Okay, so I suppose naintindihan niya natin ang meaning ng friction at induction. And sa senior high kayo, you tend to remember that when you do brush your hair, especially sa aircon na place, which means the air is rather dry. Yung comb ninyo can actually attract small pieces of paper or styrofoam or really small piece of dust. In fact, ang dust collection, why dust collect, is a matter of charges existing in the dust, so they tend to stick to other objects. And induction naman, on the other hand, is a way of charging by transferring part of movable charges, in this case in electrons, to make what you call a semi-permanent charge. It's not permanent until you discharge that. So those friction, ito ng induction, are ways to charge or electrify a certain material. Of course, not all materials can be electrified easily. Insulator, now notice that may naka-highlight dito insulators and conductors, will go there. But kung natatandaan nyo na ang insulator are devices na hindi kayo makuryentehan kapag ginamit nyo siya as a protection. And conductors, on the other hand, are the ones that allow charges to pass through. Unfortunately, it's the insulators are the ones that can be charged. And the conductors are not. Hindi mo siya pwede i-charge. Why? Because they easily discharge. On the other hand, okay, so let's look at a very simple example of the concept of the unit charge. So I'm not going to ask anymore kung ano yung, what is, for example, a quantum of ano. So very, this example is about that. Okay, it's about this one. Okay. Example is, since charges are quantized, any value of charge you read is actually a quantum charge and a number. Example, a cell phone has a maximum of 4,000 ampere hour. So, a micro ampere hour is another unit of charge based on current and by conversion is equal to Q sub T. So in this case, I'll show you pa paano siya na convert, no. So we have 4,000 microampere hour times 1 coulomb per second divided by 1,000,000 microampere. Now, 1,000,000 microampere is 1 ampere. Okay, ang microampere kasi is 1,000,000th ampere. So multiply mo yun ng 1,000,000, you just get an ampere. Now, why are you using that? That's a conversion. To convert yung microampere into a coulomb. And then yung second naman, since hour yan, no, then we convert hour into seconds by multiplying that by 3,600 seconds. So the product of 4,000 times 3,600 divided by 1,000,000 is 14.4 coulomb. And that would be equal to the charge of the cell phone that you have in terms of coulomb. So 14.4 coulomb. Now, ano yung equivalent nun? Ang unit charge of electricity daw is 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 coulomb. So to get the number of unit charges, we express the total charge Q sub T as equal to a product N, a number N, times the unit charge, meaning there is a specific number of electrons that would express, that is equivalent to 14.4 coulomb. And rearranging that formula, we have N is equal to Q sub T over E. Okay, una, Q sub T is equal to N times E. Hindi siya N, no? N times E. Hindi siya N sub E din. N, E. Rearranging it, we have N is equal to Q sub T divided by E, where Q sub T is the answer of converting a 4,000 microampere hour na battery charge. So we come up with, okay, 14.4 C divided by 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 coulomb gives you 9.0 times 10 to the positive 19 of unit charges. So back, maybe 14, that means 14.4 coulomb of charge is equivalent to 9 followed by 19 zeros na number. I don't know what you call that number, but a number followed 9 followed by 19 zeros would be the equivalent number of electrons equaling 14.4C. So yun ang meaning ng quantum of charge. Okay, so I suppose kung ano man yung question nyo dyan, you can send me or email me. Okay, alcorpus4964@gmail.com. So you can also, kung nakapost ito, you can comment. At soon as nakapost na ito, you can comment on this and then ask specific questions which I will answer in future videos. Okay, thank you very much. Good night.